Houston, we have a problem. Houston, I'm stepping out onto the ladder. She's on the roof. Yeah, we've got a problem here. Well, really, what it is can I admit that I've done been snookered? Yeah, I'm gonna have to. This gentleman, Eric Phelps, he's moving to a new platform. Flat Earth. Now, that's gonna be a little tough for some of us to take. But yes, I think there is a possibility that we've been snookered. There's a possibility that this man is a white supremacist, talking about the Mongol nation, talking about the mixing of races, and I think we are exposing this. Pay attention to what you hear, my friends. For a time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but they'll be after their own lusts, their own desires, but they will fulfill. I don't know what it's all about. Are they a plant? An intentional deceiver, a COINTELPRO or whatever, you know, Vatican coadjutor, or what is it, you know, they call them various things, and I may have reiterated those points, but flat earth, I'm sorry, I can't go there. It's a point of separation at this point. The 1200-page book, Vatican Assassins, you bet, the man is very learned, there's no question, Eric Phelps, very learned man, and you might say it was a good ride. But if they love themselves and they're not going to hold to the truth, they're not going to hold fast to the truth, then everything comes to question at that point. At that point, I stop listening and I have to discern. What's 2 Timothy 3:2 say? It says this, for men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers. Remember that movie in 1985 called Remo Williams? Fred Ward and Joel Grey. It's kind of a funny movie, but it's kind of good. It's kind of innocent in a way. 80s movies, you know. But in it, Remo goes in to kill this guy. And it's this Joel Grey character. And he says, I just want to get out of here, buddy. I just want to get out of here. They want me to kill this your leader. And he says, it's too late for that. It's too late to leave now. You're here. And that's where we're at. We're here. It's too late to leave. We've already decided we were in searching for truth. And expose things that were a little goofy, a little off. You know, we want to follow the right thing. We don't want to get caught up in stigmata and looking for silly signs, looking for angels, and hearing these phony reports of people going to heaven and everything's cool. Everybody goes to heaven. All dogs go to heaven. All these cults that we see sneaking in the church. A lot of them. Phony preachers of all kinds going down through the ages. Remember Jim Jones, Guyana? Yeah. Do you remember what happened? Everyone thought it was just some crazy preacher that caused them all to commit suicide. Turns out, MK Ultra, you betcha. There was massive drugs used, and they took those people down there under false pretenses, and they used them as slave labor. And when it was all over and did get exposed by Senator Ryan from California, they decided to murder everybody. So they sent troops down in there from various countries to kill. Necromancers, soothsayers, all these phonies. Knights of Malta. In the church? How does this all mix? Santeria? You know, what is it? How is it that we're getting so easily bombarded with all this stuff? It's because it's coming in from every devil's avenue, every street, every bus stop the devil can use, every avenue, every medium, TV, radio, podcasts, all these people coming in. And if we're not careful, like me, and this is where I have to stop and admit it, I got caught, I done got snookered. And, you know, it's not about this. It's not about, hey, I'm always right, because we know that's not true, we're not always right. We don't want to be pig heads and know-it-alls, because we know there's so much we don't know. But we do search out the truth, and we do want to find people that we can kind of trust and follow, right? Get the good information, you know, whether it's Fox News, or Alex Jones, InfoWars, or whoever it might have been, Hagman, and Steve Quayle and all these other guys selling gold and selling this and that and the other. And yeah, we've been conned, but we did learn, and it's a constant thing. It's, you know, learning is a constant path. You know, we're finding our way to God. We're finding our way, you know, to, here's another one. There's a prophetess, so-called. Yeah, lots of YouTubers that started out that way. They use YouTube to get money, fame, fortune, and lie. And to sell things, survival goods, gold, silver, or whatever it is they're trying to sell. Sometimes they're just trying to sell themselves and their religions, whatever the case may be. But yeah, I've had a wake-up call here, and I don't believe that I can trust Mr. Phelps in every way. Thus, if I can't not trust him when he goes flat earth on us, everything therefore starts to come into question. Can I trust him? Is he with us? What is his agenda? Because we see all kinds of deceivers, all kinds of liars, all kinds of satanic agendas, all kinds of people that have been deceived. How do they get so easily conned? Well, I think now it's easier to see. Some of us have been conned, and we haven't got the whole truth. We haven't got the whole truth in some of these matters. Stranger they will not follow, but flee from him, for they know not the voice of a stranger. God was telling us that my sheep know my voice, and another they will not follow. We have to avoid all these things. This world is full of all kinds of deception. Left turns, right turns, yin and yang. You know, we're all together, we're all brothers. It's a village, it's a global village. We're all just brothers trying to go to heaven. All dogs go to heaven. How about some of these other YouTubers that have lied? Trying to present themselves up as being a pastor, man of God. Some of you can trust. Yeah. There's all kinds of, a lot of hype, a lot of deception, gold dust. Survival goods. Trying to tell us the truth. They'll say, no rapture, no rapture, no rapture, no rapture. Her poster of rapture. And they're saying, we're going to have to go through it all. We're going to have to go through all these terrible torments. They're going to see all kinds of things. Zombies. Steve Quayle said there'd be demonoids coming out. Rick Joyner said there'd be demons coming all out. Just filled with demons. And there's instilling fear in people. It's a whole religion of fear. They're trying to get us to fear so they can sell us something. You got to get gold and silver. You got to get prepared. You got to get in your bunker. We've been led too many times. Many phony religions, world denomination, or domination. I said the word denomination, maybe a little slip, Freudian slip there. Not that Freud was anything to be trusted. But yes, we are being deceived, and we're going to have to be careful. We're going to be wise as serpents, harmless as doves, the Bible says. The weapons of our warfare are not carnal, pulling down strongholds through faith. Just preach the gospel is what we're going to have to do, and adhere to sound doctrine. We know the time will come, and this is it. This is the end times. It's the falling away. At first, the great falling away takes place before the rapture takes place. For those of us that are still believing in Christ's return, the blessed hope, our harpazo, that's it. Those rapture thieves, like that guy right there, a rapture thief. We know he's not the one. That's not the voice to follow. And some of these other gold dust believers and these rapture thieves collected all together, birds of a feather, telling us that maybe 19 hijackers flew into the World Trade Center. If that's your discernment, my man, you've got nothing more to say to my life. Because if you say you got discernment, if the Lord gave you wisdom, if the Lord gave you a word in season, that's right. We can't trust all these people. We can stay blood covered. You plead the blood of Jesus over your life, over your family, over your heart, over your mind, over your finances, over your job, over the people on your job, the people you care about. And really what it boils down to is, create in me, O God, a clean heart, and renew a right spirit within me, Psalms 51:10. We can't allow ourselves to be deceived and tripped up at this late date. Jesus is coming soon. And we don't have time to let any more of these deceivers and con artists lead us down a primrose path or a phony path. So God bless everyone. This is an admission. I was wrong. I followed some wrong teaching from some con artists. I do apologize. And it can help, hopefully help to expose some of those things. Well, we're going to get exposed by Senator Ryan from California. They decided to murder everybody. So they sent troops down in there from various countries to kill. Necromancers, soothsayers, all these phonies. Knights of Malta in the church. How does this all mix? Santeria. You know, what is it? How is it that we're getting so easily bombarded with all this stuff? It's because it's coming in from every devil's avenue, every street, every bus stop the devil can use, every avenue, every medium, TV, radio, podcasts, all these people coming in. And if we're not careful, like me, and this is where I have to stop and admit it, I got caught, I done got snookered. And it's not about this. It's not about, hey, I'm always right, because we know that's not true. We're not always right. We don't want to be pigheads and know-it-alls, because we know there's so much we don't know. But we do search out the truth, and we do want to find people that we can kind of trust and follow, right? Get the good information, you know, whether it's Fox News or Alex Jones, InfoWars, or whoever it might have been, Hagman, and Steve Quayle and all these other guys selling gold and selling this and that and the other. And yeah, we've been conned, but we did learn, and it's a constant thing. Learning is a constant path. You know, we're finding our way to God. We're finding our way, you know. Here's another one. There's a prophetess, so-called. Yeah. Lots of YouTubers that started out that way. They use YouTube to get money, fame, fortune, and lie, and to sell things, survival goods, gold, silver, or whatever it is they're trying to sell. Sometimes they're just trying to sell themselves and their religions, whatever the case may be. But yeah, I've had a wake-up call here, and I don't believe that I can trust Mr. Phelps in every way. Thus, if I can't not trust him when he goes flat earth on us, everything therefore starts to come into question. Can I trust him? Is he with us? What is his agenda? Because we see all kinds of deceivers, all kinds of liars, all kinds of satanic agendas. All kinds of people that have been deceived. How do they get so easily conned? Well, I think now it's easier to see. Some of us have been conned. And we haven't got the whole truth. We haven't got the whole truth in some of these matters. Stranger they will not follow, but flee from him, for they know not the voice of a stranger. God was telling us that my sheep know my voice. And another they will not follow. We have to avoid all these things. This world is full of all kinds of deception. Left turns, right turns, yin and yang. You know, we're all together, we're all brothers. It's a village, it's a global village. We're all just brothers trying to go to heaven. All dogs go to heaven. How about some of these other YouTubers that have lied? Trying to present themselves up as being a pastor, man of God. And you might say it was a good ride, but if they love the rest of themselves and they're not gonna hold to the truth, they're not gonna hold fast to the truth, then everything comes to question at that point. At that point, I stop listening and I have to discern. What's 2 Timothy 3:2 say? It says this: for men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers. Remember that movie in 1985 called Remo Williams? Fred Ward and Joel Grey. It's kind of a funny movie, but it's kind of good. It's kind of innocent in a way. 80s movies, you know. But in it, Remo goes in to kill this guy, and it's this Joel Grey character. And he says, I just want to get out of here, buddy. I just want to get out of here. They want me to kill this your leader. And he says, it's too late for that. It's too late to leave now. You're here. And that's where we're at. We're here. It's too late to leave. We've already decided we were in searching for truth and to expose things that were a little goofy, a little off. You know, we want to follow the right thing. We don't want to get caught up in stigmata and looking for silly signs, looking for angels, and hearing these phony reports, people going to heaven and everything's cool, everybody goes to heaven, all dogs go to heaven. All these cults that we see sneaking in the church, a lot of them, phony preachers of all kinds going down through the ages. Remember Jim Jones, Guyana? Yeah, we remember what happened. Everyone thought it was just some crazy preacher that caused them all to commit suicide. Turns out, MK Ultra, you betcha. There was massive drugs used, and they took those people down there under false pretenses. And they used them as slave labor. And when it was all over and did get exposed by Senator Ryan from California, they decided to murder everybody. So they sent troops down in there from various countries to kill. Necromancers, soothsayers, all these phonies. Knights of Malta in the church. How does this all mix? Santeria. You know, what is it? How is it that we're getting so easily bombarded with all this stuff? It's because it's coming in from every devil's avenue, every street, every bus stop the devil can use, every avenue, every medium, TV, radio, podcasts, all these people coming in. And if we're not careful, like me, and this is where I have to stop and admit it, I got caught, I done got snookered. And, it's not about this. It's not about, hey, I'm always right, because we know that's not true. We're not always right. We don't want to be pigheads and know-it-alls, because we know there's so much we don't know. But we do search out the truth, and we do want to find people that we can kind of trust and follow, right? Get the good information, you know, whether it's Fox News or Alex Jones, InfoWars, or whoever it might have been, Hagman, and Steve Quayle and all these other guys selling gold and selling this and that and the other.